Sideshow Radio 94.1 KPFA. I'm Aric B. DJ Chill Status is on the wheels of steels. We got a guest with us in the building right now. Ice, how you doing? Oh, I see I'm on the... Is that Instagram? Instagram Live. So yeah. Where can they log on to see that right now?
Oh, you can log on to Instagram Live on
Instagram.com/... Miss Eyes, Miss EYEZ. Eyes is here.
Eyes is in the building and she live for all the fans. What's going on with you, lady?
Oh, I've got some exciting news. I actually have a press conference March 3rd at Winter's Tavern in Pacifica, California. I've got big news and I want everybody to be there to hear about it. So that's what's going on with me.
So it's going to be March 3rd.
Yes, at Winter's Tavern in Pacifica.
Winter's Tavern. Now, will you be performing that night?
No, I will be speaking. And if anybody has questions, they can feel free to ask about my music. If there will be music, you can ask any question that you have for me or GRM Presents, my management. So, that's what's going on.
All right. So, I'm trying to pry this news out of you, but you say you can't release it to that night.
I mean, we'll try and ask something about it. I mean, I'm not just going to blatantly just tell you exactly.
All right. What's it pertaining to?
Well, it's pertaining to my music career. Okay. It's pertaining to music, period. It's definitely got a lot to do with music.
All right.
I almost slipped and almost told a part of it, the meat part. Okay. So I can definitely say it's something very exciting. It's good news. And if anybody's out there has been following my career and they're like, man, when is she gonna do this or do that? Well, I got an answer. And if you come to the press conference, you can ask me all the questions you need. And I even have a couple of gifts to give to the press or people or fans who come.
Yeah.
I have a couple of promotional material. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I'm not... Don't be like, oh, I said she's going to have 10,000 copies of CDs. No, I didn't say that.
You got a couple.
I have a couple of items to give away.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
Okay, so aside from the press conference coming on March 3rd, what else have you been working on? What's been up with you since you've been here last?
Well, since I've been here, I've actually went on tour. And I've
Wow, where?
San Mateo.
Mm-hmm.
he's laughing.
Did he do
I went
that in
to
the
San
back?
Mateo.
I wasn't gonna do that. He did that in the back.
I went to LA.
Okay, cool.
I actually met a lot of people. Let's see. I did a couple of movies. So I have a movie called The Morning After on my YouTube channel.
Okay.
It was a short film. It was actually very fun.
Who produced that movie?
Eric Hurst is the director.
Mm-hmm.
It was his first actual movie, so he was really stoked about that.
Yeah.
I had a lot of fun doing that. And
was that your first time at it?
No, it wasn't my first time, but it was the first time I got casted based on chemistry, because people usually say... I mean, it's one of those things. I'm happy, I got credit for that, because with the type of training that I have, you trust your partner that you're working with. It's always a team. With you being a DJ, you understand, you can bounce off of another DJ.
Yeah, me and Chill bounce off each other.
Yeah.
Right.
So, it felt good to get casted based on that.
Yeah.
Because I do that a lot.
So you were bouncing off the co-star? Is that what it is?
Yeah, okay. He kept saying, oh, you guys have such great chemistry. But if you want, between you and me, it's because he's cute. How can you not have chemistry with him? He's fine. That's easy to have chemistry with him. He's fine.
I know that's right.
Yeah.
I know that's right. So that was the first one.
Mm-hmm.
And what role? What was the role?
Summer. I was his... I guess you could say his girlfriend.
Okay.
crazy girlfriend, whatever you want to call.
Okay.
Call me. Yeah, I guess, I mean, I was just really happy to be in there. Yeah. It was the first time I ever forgot my lines, like, really forgot my lines, and their camera was about to die. Like, we've been shooting for, like, a long time, and it doesn't usually happen like that, but as soon as my part comes, I forget my lines, and I was like, well, that's it. Like, what? And that's never happened, and I'm telling you, I was so cool and... You know, professional. I have my coloring book, Life of an Actor. That's right. What we do. We keep coloring books in our briefcases.
Yeah.
And our scripts. Because we sit for hours and hours just waiting. So we color like we're children. And, you know, I have my lines all memorized. And I didn't want to keep going over and over.
Mm-hmm.
And then the other actors, they didn't seem like they wanted to rehearse with me. So I was just saying to myself, like, I can only read my lines so much.
Right.
Then it was my turn, and I got up there, and then all of a sudden, you know, I just got really hot, and the lights were just in my face, which is good, because that means it's good lighting. They can afford it this time, and I just was like, Johnny, Johnny.
you knew his name.
Yeah. And I was just following him and stomping around, just not saying the right lines.
Right.
And the man who wrote the lines was standing right there. Right.
No cue cards or nothing?
Cue cards in a movie?
Hey, I'm just saying.
Hey, I ain't that big yet.
Okay.
Hey, man, I'm sure if they were casting me because I'm a name, I could have requested, hey, look, my manager says I have to have my own cue cards, but I wasn't there yet.
That's right.
Yeah.
So then you did a second film after that.
You're just assuming I did a second
film. No, you said two.
Well, I did a few. I can't remember all of them.
Okay.
Yeah, but I mean, I've done extra work as well.
Okay.
Right. Yeah. Oh, I made it in a trailer of Ant-Man. Yeah.
Get out of here.
You can see the back of my head.
Get out of here.
The back of my head.
I just saw the trailer for Ant-Man yesterday and today, actually.
Good. And that's the movie we're going to go see. We're going to go see Ant-Man.
All right. That's what's up.
Because, yeah.
Now, tell me this. You did stage work before, right?
Oh, yeah.
I remember last time we talked to you, you did some stage work.
Oh, yeah. We did talk about that.
What was the big difference between doing stage work and then shooting behind the camera?
I have proof that I've done it.
Mm.
Like, you don't understand the life of, like, actually being in this field. You do so many things, and it feels like a thankless job at the end of the day. Like, I mean, you can't rely on press. You can't rely on fans.
Mm-hmm.
You can't rely on anybody. But if you do a movie, somebody's got that footage somewhere.
Right.
And I've been doing this since I was little, so...
Yeah.
I've done the filming. Like, I mean, this is actually kind of, I'm not trying to tell a sad story, but
no.
I've been filming since I was 3.
Yeah.
And I don't have any of my footage from that.
I wish I could remember right now. I want to tell you, you do have a fan. And I mean that. You got a fan. God, if I could recall that conversation, somebody would tell me that they went somewhere and they saw you playing the piano. And you were singing. It was just you, the piano, and you were singing somewhere. And they really dug what you did. I kid you not.
Wow.
You don't recall that conversation, don't you?
Yeah.
I was talking with somebody, and I was telling them about Eyes, and they said they were somewhere, and they saw her. It was just her, and you were playing on the piano. Because when I met you, you were playing on the piano.
Yeah.
We threw a show out at in Hayward years ago, and she came and performed at that show.
Oh, yeah, wow. She had, like, a little at dress on, too.
Right? Right, out at Fox's.
That's what that was.
Remember at Fox's?
Yes. I knew you at Fox's?
Yeah, I was the one putting that show on.
Wait a minute.
Yeah, at Slippery Wet. It was me and my partner in class. We used to put on Slippery Wet.
Did I have the cards? The magician cards?
She did do magic.
Yeah, magic.
Oh my God, I have footage of that show.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's on Birthday Drama.
Okay, yeah, that was the we used to put that show.
That's your show?
That was my show. We don't do that show anymore.
But, oh my God, we met before we knew each other.
How about that?
Oh my God.
So I've actually seen some, I've met somebody and they told me that they saw you somewhere else doing something similar and they said they really dug your style.
That's crazy.
I kid you not.
That's crazy. Maybe with some of this news that I have the press conference for, maybe if I heard people appreciated that I wouldn't have changed up my style.
So how have you changed up? Oh, that's what's coming in the press.
Well, no, you can ask me that. Go ahead.
Okay, how have you changed up your style?
Well, I do less of that now. I do less of singing and playing the piano.
Oh.
I got, you know, kind of tired of people not appreciating it or asking me questions about how am I using auto-tune while I'm playing the piano. Like, you know, those kind of dumb questions.
You started using auto-tune?
No, I don't use auto-tune. I'm just saying, with the people who are listening to music aren't trying to listen to live music no more.
Gotcha. Okay.
So, like, they're... I mean, I still sing and play the piano. It's no different, but my method to recording music is a little different.
Mm-hmm.
Usually when I record music, it's like I have the set song like in my mind or however I've composed it.
Mm-hmm.
It's not based on recording. It's based on song.
Yeah.
So what I'm doing now is more so like I'm more like just the producer, like the untrained producer.
Yeah.
Like I... couple of tinks here, loop this, blah blah blah, hit, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I'm doing it more like that. Now I do know how to do that because I do produce my own music, but that's not usually how I do it. I just have a song in my heart and it happens to go on the piano and I sing with it and that's it, but I'm doing something a little different this time.
That's what's up.
You're good. That was good.
All right, we're going to get into a record, though. It's time to do some Wapalicious and let DJ Chill do what he do for a hot second. We'll be right back with Eyes, and then we also got Artemis in the building, so that's going to be live, too. You know, keep it locked right here. It's 94.1 KPFA, Sideshow Radio. Cut that record, DJ Chill.
Yeah, it's on my wrist and my pinky ring. Got a bad bitch.